In this video, you'll see how to enable and allow USB debugging on an Android device whose touchscreen no longer works, although it's still possible to see something on it. Attention! For this to work, your device must be OTG compatible. If you are unsure if this is the case, type in internet the name of your device followed by OTG. This tutorial may not work with an Oppo brand device because you must first activate the OTG via the settings, which is impossible with a broken touchscreen. For this tutorial you'll need a wired mouse and an OTG adapter, USB A to USB-C or to micro USB, depending on your device. You can find one included in the box of your smartphone or buy one cheaply on internet. First, insert the mouse USB cable into the OTG adapter, and then connect the OTG adapter to your device like this. Now unlock your device using the mouse. Open the settings. Click on About Phone, at the very bottom of the page, and search for build number. Location may vary slightly between devices. Once you have found it, click on it several times in a row until the message "You are now a developer" appears. Then go back to the main menu. You should normally see an option called Developer Options at the bottom of the screen. If this is not the case, click on Additional Settings or Advanced Settings, and then on Developer Options. Now scroll down to the debugging section and enable USB debugging. When it's done, download the EVA Facial Mouse application from the Play Store, still using the mouse. Once the application is installed, open it. Click on Continue. And allow EVA Facial Mouse to overlay other app. Then click on OK. Click on Continue. And allow the app to access to your camera. Now click on Open Accessibility Settings. Click on EVA Facial Mouse, in the Downloaded Apps section. And allow this app to control your device. Click on Skip This Wizard. And finally click on OK. All you have to do now is click on Enable EVA. If you place your hand above your device, you'll see a cursor that will follow your movements. To open the settings, for example, I just have to place the cursor above the settings icon and stay still. The app launches after a few seconds. Once the application is installed and configured, disconnect the OTG adapter and connect the charging cable to your PC and then to your smartphone. A pop-up should appear, but it doesn't always. You must then click on Transfer Files using your hand, as shown previously. A new pop-up will appear, prompting you to accept USB debugging with this PC. To do this, check Always Allow This Computer and click on Allow Using Your Hand, as shown previously. There you go. USB debugging is now enabled and allowed on your device. If you want to view and control your smartphone from a PC, that's probably why you're here. I invite you to watch my video on the subject. Be aware that you won't have to reactivate or allow again USB debugging, because it's already done.